Time has now come for us to get technical. Before we go out on the pitch, are there any basic principles that you can tell us about?
Absolutely. There are quite a few. One of the most important ones, which really rarely happens in any rugby of any sort, is that the flanks have to be there on the engagement. At particularly your point of breakdown when the props explode into the scrum. The props need to win that race across the line, and obviously the flanks can aid this. What they do after that, which they generally do, is slip their bind and pretend to fly out the fly-off. Obviously the back five must explode the front three into the scrum, particularly the eighth man must be bound and ready to go into the scrum and not to be too worried about what's happening in the next movement. Mentioned winning the race across the line, the front row has really got to explode across the ground and make sure that they engage the contact points as opposed to having that engaged upon them. Other than that, everyone obviously working after the hit. Most scrummers, scrumming sides, or the better ones, after the engagement, particularly the All Blacks, you'll see them still working towards a particular point, whereas others tend to have the engagement and then relax themselves and then come with a timing shove. It's important to keep that pressure on at all times.
Got you.
Let's go through the principles of scrumming that are very important to the set piece. There are five basic principles for the set scrum. Firstly, the front row must provide a stable platform. And once this is achieved, a synchronized shove is required by all members of the scrum. The second point is that the back five need to explode the front row into the scrum. Thirdly, the front row must win the race across the center line. The front row must also be set and have the correct height and distance. And fifthly and most important, after the engagement, they must keep the pressure on. On the second point, it is important that the scrum is like a domino effect, and that the eighth man is initiating the scrum entry from behind, and that the pressure transferred through the scrum to the front row. To do that, we need the eighth man in a good pushing position on the engagement of the scrum.